want to introduce two granddaughters. I have two granddaughters here, Valerie and Laura. If they would stand up.
Government debt, international debt, it's just overwhelming, and therefore our house is built on sand. It's
not built on rocks, and therefore it can be pushed over rather easily, and therefore we must do something quickly, and that's what this campaign is all about. I have been involved in the freedom movement for a long time, since the early 70s. It was the breakdown of our monetary system then that motivated me to learn and study economics and to run for office. And yet, even a year ago, when at the request of many individuals to run for this office, I was very reluctant. I was skeptical and just couldn't believe there'd be there that many people that would show up for our anniversary party. I just didn't know that. I didn't know how the young people would respond. I didn't know how big the remnant was, since nobody knows how big the real remnant is. So evidently it was much bigger than I ever dreamed, because I have been astounded at the receptions that we have been getting. And I thank you for that. Our biggest hang-up in the early part of the campaign is we had one advisor and one secretary, and the information was leaked out that I was going to form an exploratory committee, and from that moment on, we've been overwhelmed, and it is difficult to keep up with everything, and I feel badly sometimes when the responses don't come as quickly as they should. It's also a sign of the strength and the enthusiasm of the campaign. And really, it has turned out that you're the campaign, I'm not the campaign. I am glad you have invited me to be part of your campaign. A lot has happened in this last year. We have had a lot more support, a lot more money raised than I ever dreamed. And a lot of events have occurred. There were 11, there are only 4 right now. That's a new event. The economic events have changed a whole lot in this last year as well. I was taken back a little bit the other night when Tim Russert said that now that foreign policy, essentially he said this, now that foreign policy is not the top issue, the economy is the top issue. Tonight we're going to talk about the economy. But the truth is, you can't talk about our economy without talking about our foreign policy.